Righto. So, really quick video of the new Jaguar E-Pace. Actually not new, it's been out for quite a while now. So this is the D180 all-wheel drive Jaguar. And we just close this window here. Before I go further, I just want to turn the aircon quickly on. Turn the AC down a bit so don't make too much wind noise. Quickly, I'm trying to keep this video really short, ladies and gentlemen. So, got my notes here because this is an unscripted video. I'm going to talk to you guys about how I feel about the Jaguar. So the Jaguar E-Pace, how the Europeans say, starts at 748,276 rand for the 2 litre D all-wheel drive. And it goes to 967,302 rand for the P250, which is a petrol model. It has over 180 kilowatt. The 2-liter diesel one has 132 kilowatt and 430 newton meters of torque, and it's a 9-speed transmission, and it's coupled, it's got a 56-liter fuel tank. So I've got to be honest with all of you, the E-Pace drives really, really good. This 2-liter diesel engine is the party piece here. The 132 kilowatt and 430 newton meters of torque makes this thing a treat to drive. This engine is really punchy, and to overtake and to pull away from a robot, a really impressive engine. And to me, the Jaguar sets itself apart by this effortless feel. This car really covers ground really well. The other thing you've got here is Jaguar's digital display in front of you and the infotainment system, which is okay to use. You've got Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. I obviously use Android Auto all the time. I'm going to switch back to an iPhone, but I'm going to keep my Samsung because I want to have best of both worlds. That's a conversation for another time. The other thing with the E-Pace is the amount of legroom there is at the back, but I'm really short, so it's you can't really take my word for that. Quite a bit of legroom at the back, and really nice big boot, nice comfy seats. Other good thing about the car is manual climate control switches. I can turn them to the climate I want. I can turn the fan speed. I can change where the air needs to go, if it must be through these vents or through the windscreen demister or by your feet. Really well designed and properly intuitive. I like physical buttons. Also a physical volume control for the okay Meridian sound system. I don't think this one has a top end sound system. With the bass set at neutral and the subwoofer set at neutral, quite severe distortion at higher volumes. However, at lower volumes it's punchy. I found out that you turn the bass all the way down and you turn the subwoofer all the way up, that way you get a okay balanced sound. Again, it's actually not a very impressive sound system, but certain music, certain volumes, it actually does impress. This one also has a panoramic sunroof, and it's got lane keeping assist, no blind spot warning on this model, and pretty alloy wheels. Here's Jaguar's drive selector as well. So you've got your economy, you've got rain, ice, snow, and comfort, and obviously the dynamic mode. If you floor the thing, can't even hear it there. The thing with a Jaguar, specifically the E-Pace, is you buy it because you kind of want to stand out. You buy it because you want this very Euro, you know, very chic type of experience. Like, I just climbed into this car, and already I've been getting looks from people because it's a Jaguar, you know. It's a premium car in a premium segment. It's like, people like Jaguar. Yes, I know the reliability on JLR products are a bit sketchy, but I must admit, let's try and put it in dynamic mode again just so you can hear what the diesel engine sounds like. It actually sounds really nice. It doesn't sound like a diesel at all. I mean, that's not slow. Now, for things I don't like about the Jaguar E-Pace. What don't I like about this car? Besides sketchy build quality here and there, otherwise everything you kind of do touch is quite nice. What don't I like about this car? Yo, I really don't know, eh? I really, really, really don't know. Like, it hasn't offended me at all. It hasn't made me go, I can't think of anything I don't like about this car. Come on, Yaz, there must be something you don't like about it. Okay, maybe this should have been black and not this cream color. I think I'm really nitpicking now. Yo, it's weird, eh? I actually can't think of anything I don't like about this car. It's tough reviewing a car like this here on Liberable because I'm someone who is a bit more into sporty cars, fast cars, and for me to kind of drive a car like this and give you guys my honest opinion on it is really difficult because I can't see anything wrong with it. Whereas with a sports car, I can figure out things that's wrong with it. So yeah, I hope I didn't waste your time. But thank you all so much for watching this video. Thumbs up, subscribe, share with friends and family. Be free, be you. Liberable out.